the Holy Holy.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. My brothers and sisters in Christ, welcome to the Holy of Holies. When we hear the Word of God, when we listen to the Word of God, we receive many blessings and graces from our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. My dear friends in Christ, we often have to face many tough situations in our life. When we go through difficult moments in our life, we ask ourselves, why such evil happens in my life? The evil experiences, the evil influences of this world could impact our peaceful life, and it can come in many forms, in the form of suffering, pain, death, loss of possessions, loss of job, financial crisis, you name it, mean different forms of sufferings. And we ask ourselves and we seek an explanation, why such evils happens in my life, why I go through such distress. And of course we know we have to face the consequences of our own actions, our own sins. But what if even after trying to lead a righteous life, a faithful life, why God allows such distress in my life? Why I have to go through such anguish and pain? And how can I be comforted by my faith, by the certainty of my faith? Or how can I console such people going through different forms of sufferings? When they ask questions, how can I comfort them? Romans chapter 8 verses 28 says, we know that all things work together for good for those who love God, who are called according to His purpose. Amen. This word of God is living and full of meaning. It means what it says. The word of God says, those who love God and those who are called according to His purpose. And for them, all things work together for good. We have to believe this. All things means all things. Whether it is good or bad in our eyes, all things, all unfavorable situations will work together for good, for our own good and for the good of many people. We know in the life of Joseph, our ancestor, he had to suffer the moral evil caused by his brothers. At that moment, he put his confidence in the Lord. He told his brothers after he was becoming successful that you have intended to do harm to me, but God intended to do good for my own goodness and for yours and for the life of many people around us. Praise the Lord. So Joseph could see the providence of God in his situation, in his evil situation. Praise the Lord. And as we all know, the greatest moral evil happened in the history is the crucifixion of God's Son. He was crucified and we all received the salvation. All humanity, all generation received salvation, eternal life through His sufferings. And personally, I can say in many situations, in many evil situations, experiences, my down times, in all bad times, when I look back right now, I can say that God had turned all displeasing situations into good. Praise the Lord. My dear brothers and sisters in Christ, today the Spirit of the Lord is inviting you to bring to your mind the evil things happened in your life in the past, or if it is happening right now, bring it to your mind and let us all pray. Let us all pray to see the God's providence in our situations right now. Book of Psalms chapter 56 verses 8 says, you have kept count of my tossings, put my tears in your bottle. Are they not in your record? Amen. He has collected your tears in a bottle and He has it. Praise the Lord. He's seeing the situation that you are right now. Are you ready to put your complete confidence in the Lord? Are you able to open your eyes and see God's providence in that situation? And God's mercy is right there to save each one of us and turn our situations into something good. Let us all pray for those who are suffering, all who live in despair and hopelessness. Let us all pray together in one spirit and invite the mercy of the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. Let us all pray. Lord Jesus, we thank you and we praise you. Lord, we thank you for this word of God. Lord Jesus, right now we pray in one spirit for the grace to see God's providence in all the situations of our life. in good or bad ups and downs of our life to see God's providence like your ancestor Joseph. Lord, we pray for all those who are suffering, all those who live in despair to find comfort in you. Lord Jesus, in your mighty name, we rebuke and cast out the spirit of despair, anguish and distress. We send it to the foot of the Holy Cross in the mighty name of Jesus Christ the Nazarene. Lord, right now, let every soul be washed with the precious blood. Let every wounds of sin be healed by the precious blood of Jesus Christ. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Praise you, Lord Jesus. Amen. God bless you all. All glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Amen.